Hello students, today we are doing one more problem on influence line diagram. Draw the influence line diagram for the forces in the member U3L3, U3U4, U3L3 of the frame as shown in the figure and find maximum forces developed when an UDL of intensity 40 kN per meter longer than the span moves from left to the right on bottom cord. So it is the load is moving on the bottom cord. So this is the diagram that is given to you. Height is given as well as the inclination is given. Because in this problem we are going to calculate the forces for an inclined member, and that inclined member is U3 U4. Okay, and next we are going to calculate for U3 U4 and U3L3, that is an horizontal member, an inclined member as well as an vertical member. All the three kinds of forces you will be doing in this now let the reactions at the left hand and then the right hand be R1 and R2 respectively. R1 and R2 respectively. Now let us first calculate for U3L4, that is your inclined member. So this is the inclined member. Now for this inclined member I have drawn the free body diagram over here. Now let us first consider, now this is the cut that I have given, and I have cut it into two parts, the left part and the right part. Now I am considering first the load in L1 till L3, the load to be in L1 and L3. So I will be taking the right hand side equilibrium for it. I will apply summation V. Okay. So this, if I cut it, the free body diagram will be somewhat like this, R2, and here this is force U3 L3. This is right hand side of the member and this is the left hand side of the member. When the load is in the left side, you have to take the right hand side. So when we do this resolution along V, what do I get? I get force U3L4 sine of 45 is equals to minus R2, because both are in the same direction. So when I send one on the right hand side, I will get one minus. So what will I get? I will get it as F U3L3 is equals to sine 45 is equals to R2. Now sine 45 is nothing but root 2 and this is compressive in nature. Now let us calculate the influence line diagram values for R2. Now the influence line diagram value for R2 will be like this. So when it is at L3 and when it is at L1. When the load is at L1, the ordinate will be 0. When the load is at L3, the ordinate value will be 2 divided by 6. 6 means 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and the last one, 6th part. Okay. So, the force in U3L4 is 2 divided by 6 into root of 2 when the load is at L3. Now, let us consider the left hand portion when the load is in the right hand side. When the load is on the right hand side, when it is here, now I will consider the equilibrium over the left hand side. This is the equilibrium of the left hand side. Again, I will take summation of the vertical forces R1, it will be R1 minus F U3 L4 sine 45 is equals to 0. So, what I will get? R1 is equals to, sorry, not R1, I am not calculating R1, I am calculating this. So, force in U3L4 will be what? R1 divided by sine 45, and this is tensile in nature because both the sides is having positive side. Okay, so that this is what you will be getting, R1 root of 2. Now let us draw influence line diagram for R1. When you have the influence line diagram for R1, so what will be the value? So from here this will be your influence line diagram for R1, and I have to calculate the ordinate at L4 and L7. At L7 the ordinate will be 0, at L4 the ordinate will be how much? It will be 1, 2, 3, that will be 3 divided by 6 parts. Okay, it will be 3 by 6 into root 2. So you can see here it is 3 by 6. When the load is at L7 it is 0, when the load is at L4 you will get it as 3 by 6. The ordinate is nothing but 3 by 6 root of 2. Now let us draw the influence line diagram for this. So L1 to L7 is your beam. Why I have told you this, why we are considering the bottom chord member? Because at the bottom chord member only your load is moving. Now for L1 to L, now at L3 I have got the value as root 2 divided by 3, and at L4 I have got the value as 1 divided by root 2. Okay, after simplifying this values, okay, after simplifying I have got this values. Now I have to know the base of this. Okay, what is this length? Because I have to take the area of this triangle. To know the area of this triangle, I have to know what is the length of this L3Q. Now how can I get L3Q? By using similar triangle for this portion and this portion. Okay. Next, how do I do it? I have written over here, that is L3Q divided by QL4. L3Q divided by QL4 will be equal to root 2 divided by 3, the whole divided by 1 divided by root 2. Okay. So next I want L3L4. How will I get L3L4? L3L4 is nothing but L3Q plus QL4. Okay. So after substituting and all, I'll get it as 0.4. Then L3Q is 0.4 times L3L4. So what is the length of L3L4 in the problem? You can see each part is 4 meters in length. So multiply with 4, you will get 1.6. So this distance is 1.6, okay, from L3 to LQ. From L, this is how much? This is 2 parts of 4 meter, and the remaining is, this is 3 parts of 4 meter. This is 4 minus 1.6. So 4 minus 1.6, you will get it as 2.4. So now compressive force, this is compressive, this is tensile. So compressive force is given by what? Load multiplied with the area of the triangle in the compressive side. Now let us calculate that. Nothing but half base. So this is 2 fours are 8 plus 1.6. This is the ordinate multiplied with the intensity. So you will get this answer. Similar with the tensile force, half area into the load. So area of this is how much? 4 threes are 12 plus 2.4. Okay, this will be your base. Height will be 1 by root 2 and the intensity is 40. You will get the answer as 203.65 kilonewtons. Next is influence line diagram for U3, U4. Now U3, U4 is a vertical member. U4 is an horizontal member. For this, what you have to do? You have to take movement about the end of the member. Here the member ends at U4, so I have to take movement about L3. So moment about moment about L4 is given how? AB divided by L into 1 divided by H. Now H is 4 meters, that is height of the beam. Now what is A? A is the distance between the left hand support till point L4, and B is the distance between L4 to the right hand support. Now here how many? 1, 2, 3. 3 fours are 12. So A is 12, and to the right hand side you are having again 1, 2, 3, 3 fours are 12. So here distance is 12 by 12 divided by 24 into 1 divided by 4. So this is the direct ordinate for U3, U4. And how does this distribution takes place? This distribution takes place in the form of an triangular shape. See here. Force in U3, U4 is moment at L4 divided by H. So AB divided by L into 4, and it is compressive in nature. So after doing the calculations, you will get 1.5 as the ordinate. So this ordinate at L4 is 1.5, and this is the triangular in shape. Now area of the triangle multiplied with the intensity will give you the force. Okay, this is easy. Next, to calculate U3, L3, which is an vertical member. To calculate U3, L3, which is an vertical member, I have taken a section over here. Okay, now I'll consider the load in the left hand side, and I'll take the equilibrium about the right hand side. If I take the equilibrium of the right hand side, that is summation V is equals to 0. That I what I'll get? Minus U3, sorry, that is the force in U3, L3 plus R2 is equals to 0. So I want force in U3, L3 that is equals to R2. The plus sign will become minus, so the force will become tensile in nature. This is when the load is in left hand section. When the load will go to the right hand section, what will happen? The equilibrium will be what? R1 plus force in this part. Okay, I have cut this section. So this section will come in the left hand side, and this section will come in the this section will go in the right hand side, and this will come in the left hand side. So L3, U3 is equals to 0. So force in L3, U3 is equals to minus R1. So this minus sign, I'll write it as compressive. Now I have to calculate the ordinates for R2 when it is in the left hand side section. So I have to take the influence line diagram for R2, and I have to take the ordinate at L1 and L3. So ordinate at L3 will be how much? 2 divided by 6. Okay. Similarly here, if I take the influence line diagram, this will be the influence line diagram, and the maximum ordinate will be at L4. So this is nothing but 3 divided by 6. Okay. When I take the ordinate for R1 at L4, that time I'll get 3 by 6. And for R2 at U3, I'll get it as 2 by 6. So simple thing. Okay. When it is at L1, it is 0. When it is at L3, it is 2 by 6. Next, when I consider the left hand side equilibrium, I will get at L7, I'll get 0. At L4, I'll get 3 by 6. So this is at 3 by 6. So after that, draw the influence line diagram for the member U3, L3. Then we have to calculate the forces. Now again, in the same way, L1 to Q and Q to L7. So what I have to do, again use this similar triangle. L3Q divided by QL4 is equals to 2 by 6 divided by 3 by 6. 2 by 6 divided by 3 by 6. Again, I am getting it as 0.4. So L3Q is 0.4 times L3L4. So again, I will get it as 1.6. So maximum tensile force occurs when U3L3 occurs when the load is in L1Q. So when it has occupied this area, you will be getting the positive or the tensile force. So multiply area with the intensity, you will get 64 as the answer. For compressive, you have to use the other triangle over here, that is placed over here, and this will give you the compressive force in the member. So the compressive force in U3, L3 occurs when the load is in Q2, L7, that is given by half base into height multiplied by the load. You will get it as 144 kilonewton. That is half base is Q2, L7, that is this is 12 meters plus this is 2.6 meters. So it is 14.6 multiplied by its height, that is 3/6. Okay. So you will get it as 144 kilonewton as your answer. Thank you for hearing patiently.